मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, प्रीवियस क्लास ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम एंड नेक्स्ट गो फॉर प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम, नेक्स्ट गो फॉर ग्राफिकल पार्ट ऑफ केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम। ग्राफिकल पार्ट ऑफ केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम, with rate and with respect to time, rate and time. This is the rate you have calculated as y-axis and time is taken as x-axis. Already any reactants and products, anyone, A plus B gives rise to irreversible reactions, C plus D, this is the reactants, this is the products. Reactants and products. Yes, first reactants are more concentration. Rate means change in concentration. Rate means what? Rate is equal to change in concentration. Products and reactants. Reactants with time. Unit time is called as rate. The rate is taken as a y-axis and time is taken as a x-axis. First reactants has more percentage present, that's why rate is this one the right. And products is first zero, this is the zero, that means this is the rate, that means the concentration of reactants. This is the products. At this one point, two equilibrium is present. Reactants or products are equal. That's why that is called as. This is the rate of forward reaction. This is the rate of backward reaction. It is called as. Rb. In this time is called as Rf is equal to Rb. At equilibrium, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. This is the rate of forward reaction. This is the rate of forward backward reaction. It is indicated by Rb, rate of forward reaction indicated by rate of Rf. Concentration more is present, that's why more, that means the products is at 0 to increases. That's why rate with time is graph is rate of forward reaction is equal to equilibrium, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. And another graph, concentration with time. Concentration is taken as a y-axis, time is taken as a x-axis. This time, that means this is also reactants. Reactants always first increases and then decreases. And products always increase, that means first decreases and then increases. That meaning concentration of reactants, concentration of reactant decreases and concentration of product increases at this point at equilibrium. And another graph, same graph, that means concentration with the time, with the concentration is taken as a y-axis, time as a taken as a y, that means the x-axis. concentration is taken as a y axis, time is taken as a x axis. This is the reactants, this is the products. At this point, that means concentration of reactant and that meaning equilibrium. These are three graphical parts is chemical equilibrium. First one, rate with respect to time, concentration with respect to time. This is the reactants, this is the products, this is the product. And another one, concentration of reactants, this is the products. If the concentration of reactants is decreases, products also increases. These are time, that is called as, these are called graphical part of chemical equilibrium. Next, another part, another case, law of mass action. Law of mass action. What is mean by law of mass action? Law of mass action is discovered by, that means Ulberg and Waage. Ulberg, two scientists. Ulberg and it is discovered by law of mass action introduced Ulberg and Waage. And what is mean by law of mass action? Suppose you have to write the A for AA plus BB. Let us consider one reaction CC plus DD. Now write it what in this law for chemical one reaction is there. A, small b, small c, small d is a stoichiometric coefficients. Small a, small b, small c, small d is a stoichiometric coefficients. Small a, small b, small c, small d is a stoichiometric coefficients. Rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to the molar concentration of reactants or active masses of products. Reactants are products, that means molar concentration of products, active masses of reactants, A rise due to A power A, B power B rise due to stoichiometric coefficients is called as law of mass action. Suppose any reaction, this is the product, okay, this is a forward reaction also there and backward reaction also there. Rate of forward reaction is one. Rate of backward reaction. Is directly proportional to concentration of C concentration of B power D. That meaning rate of forward. It is indicated by RF, it is indicated by RB. Rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to molar concentration of molar concentration means the active mass. stoichiometric. Stoichiometric coefficients. That is called as a law. That means the active masses of the products. Products means reactants and the products. Okay, law of rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to the molar concentration. Concentration is indicated as the square bracket. Concentration is indicated by square bracket. Molar concentration of the active mass, molar concentration or active masses of the products. The products means reactants are the products. And raised to power equal to stoichiometric coefficient, that is called as a law of mass action. Rate of chemical reaction, any chemical reaction, directly proportional to the molar concentration. Concentration is indicated by square bracket of the products and raised to power. The stoichiometric coefficient is called as law of mass action. What is mean by active mass? Active mass or molar concentration is the same. Active mass or molar concentration is same. Molar concentration is equal to active mass. Molar concentration is equal to active mass. Okay, you have this active mass. Active mass is equal to number of moles of by divided by volume. That means active mass of a substance. The active mass of a substance is dissolved in volume of the liter of the solution. Okay, active mass is equal to number of moles by volume in liters, but in solid liquids and gas, active mass in gas and liquid is equal to molar concentration. In solids, active mass of solid is a unity, that means a constant. This is the active mass. The active mass of a substance dissolved in volume of the liter of the solution is called as active mass. The active mass in gas and liquid state equal to molar concentration. Solid active mass of solid is unity, that is constant. Now next, active mass is equal to molar concentration into reactivity coefficients. In activity coefficient, in this is the active mass is equal to molar concentration into activity coefficient in dilute solutions. Solution of activity coefficient is less than 1. This is the active mass. law of mass action, rate of chemical reaction is directly proportional to the molar concentration of reactants or molar concentration of products or anyone. That means that to raise it to power, stoichiometric coefficients is called as law of mass action. Active mass is a substance is dissolved in a number of moles per liters. Active mass in gas and liquid is equal to molar concentration. Active mass of solid is unity, that is constant. Active mass is equal to molar concentration into activity coefficient. Activity coefficient in dilute solution is less than, greater than or equal to 1. Concentration of solution less than 1. Okay, next go for law of chemical equilibrium. Law of chemical equilibrium. Listen carefully. Let us consider the one reaction. Let's consider a reaction. One is a AAB at a reversible reaction at equilibrium. CC plus DD. According to law of mass action, this is the rate of forward reaction, this is the rate of backward reaction. First, according to law of mass action, the rate of forward reaction is equal to is directly proportional to the concentration of A power A, concentration of B power B. Therefore, rate of forward reaction is expressed as Rf. Rf is directly proportional to the concentration of A power A, concentration of B power B. Rf is equal to Kf, concentration of A power A, concentration of B power B. Rf means rate of forward reaction. Kf means equilibrium constant in forward reaction. Equilibrium constant in forward reaction. Forward reaction. And next, rate of backward reaction. Rate of backward reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of C power C, concentration of B power B. Rb is directly proportional to the concentration of C power C, concentration power B power B. How can also express as Rb is equal to Kb into concentration of C power C, concentration of D power D. At equilibrium, Rf is equal to Rb. Rf means what we calculated? Kf, concentration of A power A, concentration B power B is equal to Kb, concentration of C power C, concentration of B power D. How to write it? Kf by Kb is equal to what we calculate is concentration of C power C, concentration of B power B by concentration of A power A, concentration of B power B. Kf by Kf means equilibrium constant in a forward reaction. Equilibrium Kb means what we have related to. Kb is equal to equilibrium constant in a backward reaction. Okay, Kf by Kb is equal to K. This is the Kf by Kb, rate of that means equilibrium constant in forward reaction of equilibrium constant of backward reaction is equal to K. K means the equilibrium constant. What is meant by equilibrium constant? Equilibrium constant. Kf by Kb is equal to what? K. Kf by Kb is equal to K. Kf by Kb is equal to K. K means equilibrium constant. Equilibrium constant. What is meant by K? K definition, equilibrium constant. Already you know the ratio of Kf by K means K is equal to, you have read it, what? K is equal to concentration of C power C, concentration of B power B, concentration of A, concentration of B power B. That means equilibrium constant definition, the ratio of ratio of molar concentration of products to the molar concentration of reactants and each raised stoichiometric stoichiometric coefficients at constant temperature is called as equilibrium constant. Ratio of molar concentration of products to the molar concentration of reactants and each rise to the stoichiometric rise to power the stoichiometric coefficients A, B, small A, small B, small C, small D is also stoichiometric coefficients. Small A, that means small C, small A, small B, small D, all these are stoichiometric, that is small A, that means stoichiometric coefficients. Okay, equilibrium constant in terms of concentration, equilibrium constant in terms of in gaseous case, have to read the partial pressure, equilibrium constant in terms of number of moles, equilibrium constant in terms of number of moles, equilibrium constant in terms of mole fraction. Listen carefully. Equilibrium constant. Already equilibrium constant means what? The ratio of the molar concentration, molar, the concentration of the products to the concentration of the reactants, each raised to some power the stoichiometric coefficients. Equilibrium constant in terms of concentration formula. In terms of concentration, it is denoted by Kc. Kc is equal to any reaction, AA plus BB in reversible reaction, Cc DV. So this is the concentration of C power C, concentration of D power D, concentration of A power A, concentration of B power B. This is the Kc. In gaseous case, in gaseous reaction, it is expressed in partial pressures. Pressures. That's why equilibrium constant in equilibrium constant in constant in pressure or partial pressure, it is denoted by Kp. K Kb is equal to, you have to write it all this equation, basic equation. Kb is equal to P power C, Pc power C into Pd power D, Pa power A into Pb power B. This is the Kb equation, equilibrium constant in a pressure. And another one, equilibrium constant in a number of moles. It is denoted by Kn. Equilibrium constant in terms of number of moles. Basic reaction is this one. A, that means Kn, you have to write it, Kn is equal to constant number of moles of C power C, number of moles of D power D, upon number of moles of A power A, number of moles of B power B. This is the number of moles in terms of equilibrium constant in terms of number of moles. And another one, equilibrium constant in terms of mole fraction. Mole fraction, it is denoted by Kx. How to write it? Basic equation is this one. Kx is equal to x c power c, x d power d, upon x a power a, x b power b. This is the mole fraction, equilibrium constant in terms of mole fraction, in terms of concentration, in terms of pressure, equilibrium constant in terms of mole number of moles, equilibrium constant in terms of mole fraction. Okay, next we go for the relation between Kb and Kc. Listen carefully. The relation between Kb and Kc. Listen, according to ideal gas equation, PV is equal to what? PV is equal to nRT. PV is equal to nRT. If you have write it, P is equal to N by V RT. N by C is equal to, therefore, concentration is equal to number of moles by volume. P is equal to, you have write it, CRT. Concentration, it is indicated by square bracket. Concentration is indicated by square bracket. That means, you have write it, PA. What you have to PA means what? Concentration of C power C, RT, sorry, concentration of A power A, RT. Suppose you have write it to PB, PB concentration of B power B, RT, TC, the concentration of C, C power C, RT, PD, you have write it to concentration of D, RT. Okay, but now have to write it, the Kb is equal to, already discussed, no? Kb is equal to what formula? Kb is equal to P C power C, P D power D, P A power A into P B power B. Okay, Kb is equal to, we have Pc. Pc, you have to write it what? Concentration of C power C, RT into, this is the CRT, and PD means what, you have read, concentration of D power D, RT power D, D power D, RT, D, and upon PA means what, you have read it, concentration concentration of A or T power A and concentration of B or T concentration of A. This is Kc. We already know that Kc is equal to what? Concentration of C power C, concentration of B power B by concentration of A, concentration of B power B. How to write it? Kp is equal to Kc into RT C plus B minus A plus B. C plus B minus A plus B. A plus B. This is the C plus B minus A plus B. Any reaction, now write it, any reaction A plus BD in reversible reaction CC plus BD. This is the reactants. Reactants. This is the word products. Reactants and the products. Now write it over the change in delta N is equal to change in number of moles of delta number of moles of products minus number of products minus number of moles of reactants. C plus D, number of moles of that means delta NZ is equal to change in number of moles of the number of products means C plus D minus A plus B. That's why you have created what Kp is equal to Kc into RT power delta NZ. This is the relation between Kp and Kc. Ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT, P is equal to N by V RT, P is equal to CRT, PA is equal to, you have write it what? PA concentration of power RT, B concentration B power RT, C concentration CRT, P. Okay, KP always discuss KP, you have write in terms of KP, PC power C, PD power D upon PA power A into BP power B, concentration of C, RT power B into concentration of B, RT, B, concentration of A, RT power A, concentration of B, RT power B. How to write it for relation between KP and KC? KP is equal to KC into RT power delta NZ. Next, the product part relation Kp is equal to Kc into RT power delta.